Hey, thank you for coming by Tori Magoo 44. It is the third day of ex-Scientology tips for the holidays. And I wanted to play you one of the songs that absolutely started me waking up. And I'll tell you why after I play it, but I'm going to play it right now. Here you go. Now, we're not there yet, but I listened to this song over and over. It had to do with joy. And I remember when I was just a little kid in a show. And we're coming up to it. It wasn't the religious part that got me into it, it was the joy, the love in this music and Dolly Parton, and it brought me back to when I was a little kid. And I'm going to show you, I was at this play that I was in as a little kid, and I'd totally forgotten all of it. And they're out doing this song, and my parents are in the audience. And this was my part. We're coming up to it. They'll probably take this up on YouTube, but it's a great song. Okay, here we go. They put me out on the stage. Isn't that the best? Now, I know if you're not religious, which I'm really not, it isn't the part about religion that I love. It's just the beauty of the music, you know, and that's what's incredible about it. So that was really, I listened to that song about 80 million times the Christmas before I left. And I just kept, it twigged something in me, right? Something before I was a Scientologist, before I was in the mind control and everything. And this tip of day three is on love and sex and really family. And one of the biggest abuses, in my opinion, that the Church of Scientology does is they cut off that love from loved ones if you don't go along with their program. They break up families, literally. Parents who can't talk to children. Children who can't talk to their parents. My husband won't talk to me, says I left him, which he knows I didn't. And I told him that. I said, my door's open. Come on in. I don't know where you live. I don't know where you work. So don't say I left you. I left a cult, right? And it's the same for everyone else. If they don't want to get in Scientology, that is no reason on this Christmas 2009 for you, if you're lurking and listening to this, pick up the phone, call your parents. Go see your parents. It's Christmas time. It's time to share in the love and the joy of this world. You won't have your parents for that long, so you got to celebrate them while you do. I'm going to read to you, this also has to do with sex, right? Love and sex. That's what Hubbard originally said the second dynamic was. It was love, sex, and the rearing of children. So I thought, well, let me look up, what does he say about sex? Since I'm defining things, you know what I mean? I got the tech dictionary, right? So let's look it up. I'd never really looked it up. I was shocked to read what he says for the first definition. Okay, listen to this. Sex, one, the body's single effort to make something out of nothing is resident in sex. And in this culture, at our time, sex is a degraded and nasty thing which must be hidden at best, and babies are something not to have but to be prevented. Yikes! Thus, even sex has been made to parallel the something into nothing impulse. That's number one on sex. There's There's his definition of six, and see, it says the body's single effort to make something out of nothing. I mean, and that it's turned into degraded and nasty thing which must be hidden at best. Ew! That's number one in their definition of sex in their technical dictionary. Now again, I know their twist on it, and I'm not going to waste time on it. The point is, first of all, if you join the Sea Org or you're thinking of joining the Sea Org, children are no longer allowed in the Church of Scientology Sea Organization. Now that doesn't mean all the people in the Church of Scientology, just the Sea Organization. But if you're thinking of joining, number one, it is a billion-year contract. Read Nancy Maney's My Billion-Year Contract. It's at mybillionyearcontract.com. And Mark Headley's book, which is Blown for Good, at blownforgood.com. And both of those will give you a very good feeling of what it's like. But there are no children allowed in the Sea Org anymore. That's a whole nother story, and I've made a video on it. But basically, the kids were going to, they did join gangs here in Los Angeles, and so OSA decided, okay, no more kids. So now, I mean, I didn't know this until I left, but they now actually enforce abortions, which is just horrible, or they kick them out. So, love, sex, and the rearing of children, now they've changed that definition. I don't have the new one, but it's pretty pathetic for a church to have that kind of thing. So again, this is about love, and love is one of the most wonderful things in the world. All of us, no matter who we love, we can love them more. You know, our friends we could love more, our neighbors we could love more, and the more love that went around, the better off things are. They really are. There's a lot of shit going on now. It's a hard time. But take time to spread kindness and love and compassion. And realize that in Scientology, that almost doesn't exist. That was one of the reasons I started waking up, because I thought, where's the compassion? Where's the love? You know, it's like everybody's bustling around, busy. I just saw the Ideal Org, you know, their whole video on that, you know, and I know some of the people in it. And it's like, they've run that trip over and over and over, and it never works, because they never do what the people really need and want. So anyway, you can keep bustling around and DM. You can try to make the field do what you want, but it's toast, baby. You lost it. You didn't do what you should have done. Now the key people have left, or you have them locked up. Where's the love in that? Speaking of that, he does have the top executives locked up. So now he's thrown it over to the field saying, you guys find the buildings. You guys get the money. You guys run it. Why? Because he doesn't have anybody to run it anymore. We've all left. So, if you're in, come on out. We're having a great time. It is a wonderful Christmas. And if you are staying in, at least call your loved ones and share your Christmas with them and the love that you have and your holidays. If you're celebrating Hanukkah, happy Hanukkah. And to everyone there, I love you. Thank you for coming to my YouTube site. All right? And have an excellent holiday. And there you go. I hope that helped you a little bit.